by my colleague, Kaylee Van Kampen.
Hi, I'm Kaylee. It's so nice to see so many of you here today. This is, like many royals, I have yet to miss a royal in my life, so I'm very excited to be here and be joined with Grace.
As much as we would love to see all of your faces and have an interactive session, all lines have been muted and there will be no videos on.
So things may feel like they've come to a standstill, but learning and connection can continue with RBC Future Launch at Home. In addition to creating virtual workshops like the one we're participating in today, we have created RBC Future Launch at Home, which allows you to easily navigate through our partner-hosted virtual skill development workshops, online learning modules, and mental well-being support and services. You can easily access diverse virtual learning and mental well-being resources all in one place, helping you to do three things. Firstly, nurture your mental well-being. Secondly, improve your creative career and life skills. And thirdly, keep connected. Please see the above URL at rbc.com/future-launch-at-home to learn more about these resources.
Before we begin, let's take a moment to self-reflect on why you are here today and what you want to get out of this presentation. Maybe you're curious what this session is about, or maybe you want to learn how to build your own personal brand. Regardless of why you are here today, you've came to the right workshop. Personal brand sounds like some corporate buzzwords, but really, what is it? Over the next hour, we will talk about the basics of a brand, what is it and what makes a good one, how your first impression, how you show up professionally and on social media can make or break your personal brand, how to build a personal brand that's meaningful to you, give you tips to help you build an effective elevator pitch, and last but not least, we want to have fun.
So before we begin, let's learn a little bit more about Grace and myself. So Grace, you went to the University of Guelph, right?
That's right, Kaylee. I went to the University of Guelph and graduated in 2018 with my Bachelor of Commerce and majored in food and agricultural business.
So fun fact about Grace and I, we actually both went to the University of Guelph, graduated in 2018, and we had several classes together and competed. We even competed in a university marketing competition together in Kansas City, so that was pretty exciting for us. So on that note, Grace, who's your favorite superhero and what qualities do you admire of that superhero?
I would have to say my favorite superhero is Wonder Woman, as she is compassionate, outgoing, caring, and even a little stubborn at times, something that I can actually relate to. How about yours, Kaylee?
I'm going to have to say Iron Man, because he's always looking to help, support, and save his community. He really cares about those around him. So the reason why we ask about superheroes is because often the qualities you admire of someone are the qualities that you already have within yourself. Keep those qualities in mind, as they are your superpower and will learn to use them later to help you build your personal brand.
Now, let's talk about brand. What is a brand?
That's a great question, Grace. So you can see this symbol. What comes to mind when you see this brand, Grace?
So I automatically think, obviously, McDonald's. I would say when I see McDonald's, I don't necessarily see it as a healthy choice, but it's definitely fast, it's accessible, convenient, and I admire the work they've done with giving back through the Ronald McDonald Initiative.
Yeah, I totally agree with you on those points. They're great. So for companies, a brand is how they see themselves, as well as how the public sees them. A brand is about image and reputation. The ultimate goal for any company is to have a positive and professional image. So what makes a good brand? A good brand is consistent no matter where you go. For the best brands, people see the brand the way that the owner of the brand wants to be viewed. McDonald's can also be seen as a good brand because it's consistent. You get the same experience from them every single time. McDonald's may not have the best food, but they aren't marketing themselves as a high-end restaurant. So great, who has a brand?
Everyone has a brand, not just big companies. Even if you have not worked on your brand, you have a brand and have been sharing it with the world around you.
Think about your personal brand. Think about what makes you unique. Think about what...
It's important that you have the opportunity to build your personal brand with intent. So you are telling your story in the ways of how you would want to be seen, instead of letting others dictate your narrative.
When thinking about your personal brand, think about what makes you unique. Think about what experiences or interests you have that will make you stand out. I wish I had known that when I first started job searching. Instead of trying to fit a certain mold, I wish that I had focused more on what was unique to myself, because as soon as I started doing that, everything started feeling more authentically me.
So think of your brand through two elements. One, how do you define yourself? And two, how do others define you? What's that story or narrative they're going to share when they talk to other people about you? What would they be thinking about after your interaction with them has ended?
A personal brand is your brand, so it's the whole you. On the screen, you'll see what makes up your brand. At the center of your brand is your purpose, core values, and beliefs. Your personal brand also includes what you say, how you communicate, and what you share about the value you bring to your work, your friends, your family, and more. And what you do, your visible qualities that others see the experience or the perceptions and expectations others form of you. Both should match who you are at the core. What makes a good corporate brand also applies to a good personal brand. You'd want to have a consistent, positive, and professional branding that shows others how you want to be seen. Your brand needs to be true to who you are. Fake it until you make it is not a great approach in building your brand, because your brand can be ruined in a split second if you can't live up to who you said you are. So how do you live up to who you said you are? Demonstrate skills that you've presented in your interview or resume and walk the talk. Let me provide you with some examples. So if you don't know how to use Excel, don't say you are an Excel expert on your resume. If you say you want to be involved in volunteering opportunities, make sure you raise your hand when opportunities come knocking at your door. So for me, I am bilingual in both French and English, so I have it listed on my resume. But if I didn't feel as though I could carry a conversation or even write in French, it's not something I would want to include on my resume, as it's likely something I would be tested on, either in an interview or throughout the application process.
Oh, hi, you work for a bank? My name's Sean, and I would really like to work for a bank. More about me? Well, I graduated from college a couple years ago. Can't say my program was that useful, but I learned a couple of things, and I guess it's better to learn something rather than nothing, right? Since then, I've kind of been exploring my options. So I work part-time as a dog walker, so I guess you could say I'm a real people person. One second. Right, okay. For fun, I like to travel and read and mostly binge watch a lot of TV. And so I was kind of thinking of starting my own blog, but I just don't have the time. Anyway, I would really like to work with you. Where was it that you worked again?
So great. What kind of impression did Sean make when you first met him? You might be muted, Grace.
Sorry about that. When I first met Sean, I would say he was not necessarily dressed very professionally. He didn't stand straight. He was very, all over the place, and even his train of thought was definitely all over the place. He wasn't overly confident and didn't really seem to have a clear set goals or intentions in mind when he was talking to the recruiter.
Yeah, I completely agree. It's not really someone you'd want to hire, and certainly not someone you'd want to work with, given their lack of professionalism. So, Grace, have you ever been guilty of doing some of the stuff that Sean has done in this video?
Oh, sure. I would say there's definitely times when you might meet people and you aren't necessarily prepared to have a good conversation with them, and you have to be careful and mindful because you never know who you might meet and what connections they may have that could benefit you in the future.
For sure. And if you could help Sean redo this introduction, what would you do differently?
I think I would have Sean introduce himself, dress a little professionally, be clean, not go on his phone if it were to ring and just ignore it, and have a clear idea of what exactly he is looking to do.
Absolutely. So I'm sure a lot of you listening today have judged your book by its cover. It's not fair, because what's inside should really be more important. And eventually, this does matter, but often not right away. John, since you're out of this video, did you really get to know him that well? You were very quick to judge based on how he showed us who he was. We only have one shot at making a first impression, and likely you only have a small window when you meet someone to make that impression, share a message, or create an opportunity. You want to be prepared so that when you have the chance to make that first impression, it's going to be a good one.
So professional presence is how you show yourself to others in professional settings. It's what you say and how you say it, how you act, your body language, how you dress, how you interact with others, and so much more. Your professional presence is an important part of your personal brand, because a good professional image can help others have a positive impression of you and want to get to know you better. There are a few things you can do to put your best self forward. Body language. So think about how you carry yourself and how that tells people about who you are. You can check out Amy Cuddy's TED Talk, Your Body Language Shapes Who You Are, for some expert tips on how to use body language. Dress for success would be another one. So show who you are by how you present yourself to others. It does not mean you always have to show up in a suit and tie, but neat, tidy clothes and tied shoes can go a long way to make that good impression.
So speaking of first impressions, we spent a lot of time talking about what you can do in order to have a good professional presence and make a good first impression. But how others see you is not limited to in-person interaction. Most of us have an online presence, and how you are representing yourself on the internet can have major impact on your professional reputation. Think about the brands that you've built on social media. That's through Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, and recently TikTok. What types of posts, pictures, videos, and comments do you post, and what do they say about you? If you think that privacy settings will protect you, you could be wrong. Sure, you want to post those crazy spring break pictures, but even with groups and filters, you never know who will find them and how they could be spread, with or without your knowledge. If in doubt, ask yourself, what did my grandma think? What would my grandma think if she saw these photos?
So, Kaylee, let's put you into a hiring manager or recruiter's shoes for a moment. What would you do if you came across posts like these from your employees or potential employees?
Certainly, the first thing I did when I went on social media to search a future employee of mine, and his profile picture was him with beer against his face and looking like he's drunk, it's not going to leave me with a first impression. And it's not going to be someone I want to hire. Same thing is if someone's tweeted saying their old boss is a complete idiot. That's not going to be someone I want to employ, that's for sure. So did you know that 92% of employers hired directly from social media in 2015? If we think that was in 2015 and social media has become more relevant today, I'm sure it's a lot higher than 92% now. 79% of social media-based hires were through LinkedIn, and 55% of recruiters have reconsidered a candidate based on their social media profile. You know, this is actually good news, because if you're doing it right, your strong, positive online presence can actually position you for future opportunities and career growth. For example, if I were to share this event on my LinkedIn profile, not only can I profile the good work that our team is doing, I can also position myself as a thought leader in the area of career development and new strategies. So some suggestions for you guys listening today. Using a great profile picture can get you 14 times more views. So take the time to get a professional picture done. Don't be that guy with the beer up against his face. Follow companies that you admire and or want to work for, and search for hashtags that can help you in your job search. So, for example, I'm interested in banking and agriculture, so something I would search for a hashtag on would be agriculture banking.
So we went through many do's and don'ts of a personal brand. Now let's think specifically about you. What is your brand?
So Jeff Bezos, who's the founder of Amazon, he famously said, personal branding is what people say about you when you leave the room. So what do you want people to say about you after you leave the room? What impressions do you want to leave with them? Maybe you have a clear idea of what your personal brand is, or maybe you haven't given it much thought until now. Both are totally normal.
You might have an idea of what you want people to say about you when you leave the room. So let's take it a step further and put who you are and what you are good at on paper. So grab a piece of paper and write down the answers to the following question. Kaylee, would you mind writing your answers down as well?
For sure.
So here are the questions. I am good at, I value, I am interested in, I have experience with, I look forward to developing, and I hope one day. So don't limit yourself to work-related strengths. Feel free to share work or life examples. Try to focus on the first things that come to mind as you fill out the answers. If you're stuck trying to come up with something, think about the good things others have said about you. So once again, the questions are, I am good at, I value, I am interested in, I have experience with, I look forward to developing, I hope one day. So, Kaylee, do you mind sharing your responses?
For sure. So, I am good at networking and connecting with people. I value leadership, volunteering, and community. I am interested in agriculture and specifically dairy. I have experience with farming, banking, and public speaking. I look forward to developing my leadership skills, and I hope one day to be a people manager.
That's awesome, Kaylee. So maybe some of you might have experience with babysitting. You may think babysitting doesn't require any skills, but think again. You have to be caring and patient because it's not a small task to take care of a child. You have to be personable because you have to build trust with a child. You got to be organized because you have to help clean up toys when done and keeping a routine and a schedule. You have to be flexible and a quick learner as you have to adapt to a child's ever-changing needs and demands very quickly. Another example could have been basketball. Maybe one of you enjoys basketball. So that would mean that you are very disciplined because of the training schedule and routine. You would also be a team player because you have to work together towards a team goal. Reliable would also come to mind, as well as great time management, because you would not only have to show up for practice, but games, and also you've got to be on time. Driven would also come to mind because you have to enjoy competition and you have to work hard to achieve those goals. So now that you have a chance to think about what you would like to be known for, we can use it to your advantage in today's world of work.
So as we've been working through telling your story, how many of you know what an elevator pitch is? An elevator pitch is basically a sales pitch that markets you in a short period of time. It's a short and memorable soundbite that introduces who you are and what makes you unique. It should be natural and easy to understand. In theory, you could use your elevator pitch to introduce yourself to someone you meet by chance in an elevator. There are many more opportunities aside from elevator rides to use your elevator pitch. We'll talk more about where and when later. Also be mindful that your pitch might be different depending on the situation or the person you're meeting. Now let me show you some examples of elevator pitches.
Hi, my name is Allison. It's really nice to meet you. I studied global development at Queen's University and have always had a keen interest in social impact. I worked on several youth-focused development projects throughout my time there, and I'm currently working in corporate citizenship, focused on how employees engage with their communities. I'm really interested in the work that you're doing, as it sounds pretty similar to the work that I'm doing. I'd love to connect over LinkedIn or maybe grab a cup of coffee.
Hi, my name is Dave Day, and nice to meet you. I realize there's an opportunity open on your team for a policy development role, and I think I might be a good fit given the various experiences I've had working in the community on different files such as child welfare, policing, and healthcare. Would it be okay if I followed up with you on LinkedIn?
So now that we've had time to go through those examples and see how they've conveyed their elevator pitch to us, Grace, let's start with you and hear your elevator pitch. Where do you work, Grace?
So I work at RBC.
So when someone provides us with a one-worded answer, it's very easy for me as an employer to just end the conversation and walk away. By hearing Grace just say RBC, it didn't really captivate my attention. I don't know anything about her or her interests. So Grace, think about what RBC is and what you do at RBC and maybe what your passion is about. Try to give people something that they can ask a question back to. So Grace, let's try again. Where do you work?
Sure. My name is Grace Mullen, and I work for RBC as an agricultural account manager where I get to help clients every day reach their financial goals. I am passionate about the industry, being from a cash crop and hog farming operation myself, and I enjoy helping clients achieve their dreams.
Thanks for sharing, Grace. So as you heard, let's build our own elevator pitch now. So grab a piece of paper. And let's just take a few minutes to go through this. But first, before we start, I'm going to walk you through three main and key important pieces of information to take in so you can build that. So firstly, who are you? Secondly, what's unique about you and what do you have to offer? And thirdly, suggestions of a next step. So who are you? As you noticed, Grace first introduced herself. Then, if you were, for example, a student, you'd maybe want to include your school, the program that you're studying, your current job if you have one, and maybe a team that you're working with. Make sure you are making a connection here. Why do they care about you? So, for example, if you met someone that you recently saw a presentation that they gave, you could say, I really enjoyed your speech on whatever subject, I'd like to learn more. And I believe that you have a marketing coordinator role, open on your team that I'd be really interested in. The second point is what's unique about you and what do you have to offer? So think about this as your value proposition. What are your major accomplishments, your unique skills, and or your passions? Make sure you communicate your skills or passions in a way that is meaningful and memorable. It should be captivating, so the person is also eager, excited, and thrilled to learn more about you and connect with you. So some suggestions for next step is the third one. This is where your call to action is. So let others know what you're looking for and how they can help you. So for example, you could ask, would it be okay if I connected with you on LinkedIn? Or I'd love to take you out for a coffee sometime. Or you could ask, I have some great articles that I can share with you. So some additional tips on building your elevator pitch would be to think about how you can capture a person's attention and spark their curiosity. You can start by making sure your pitch is purposeful, so you are producing value to your target audience. Don't be afraid to hone in on your uniqueness. Demonstrate the things that differentiate you and that can set you apart from the competition. An elevator pitch should be natural, honest, and authentic. You don't want to sound like you're bragging about yourself. And depending on the scenario, your elevator pitch shouldn't be longer than 30 seconds. Because think about it, you're on an elevator, and what happens if they're getting off on the second floor? So now would be the time to grab that piece of paper to build your elevator pitch. Don't forget to use what you've already written with Grace when you went through your accomplishments, your skills, your passions, and your goals. You may not be able to fit everything on your story sheet into a pitch, so just make sure you include a few points that you highlighted.
So now that you have your elevator pitch ready, you're going to practice it with a friend, a parent, or a sibling. So Kaylee, as practice, let's go back to fourth year. When you and I were at the University of Guelph attending a job fair, do you want to share your elevator pitch you would have used with recruiters?
Absolutely. So this would be my elevator pitch. So hi, my name's Kaylee, and I am a fourth year OAC student studying a Bachelor of Science in Agriculture. I grew up on a dairy, beef, and sheep farm in Dufferin County, and I'm very passionate about helping farmers succeed. I am very familiar with RBC and your agriculture account manager role, but could you please explain your internship role and what the day-to-day would look like as an intern?
Awesome, Kaylee. I love it how you already had that knowledge that they were hiring for an ag account manager, and you could really tie in your own experiences to it.
Do you mind sharing us your elevator pitch as well, Grace?
Sure, I'd love to. So what I would have said is, my name is Grace Mullen, and I am in my fourth year studying food and agricultural business. I am from a cash crop and hog farming operation in Essex County. I am bilingual in French and English, and I am very community-oriented. What positions are you looking to hire for today?
Thanks for sharing, Grace. So let's take Grace's elevator pitch and kind of break it down. So let's think about, was it clear? So did she say what she meant? For example, Grace explained what she was studying, what year she was in, and that she was interested in agriculture. So the next one is it concise? So are you rambling on or trailing off in conversation? So remember, it's important to keep it within 30 seconds, because at a job fair, there's people coming, like, nonstop. Is it compelling? Do you catch your audience's attention? So notice that Grace said she was bilingual and grew up on a farm. So this automatically sets her apart from the competition. Does it communicate your value? Do you showcase what your strengths are? So notice, again, that Grace and I both mentioned that we grew up on a farm, we studied agriculture, and we're hoping to apply for an agriculture position. So we're staying within our audience, for sure. And does it provoke further curiosity? Is your audience interested to learn more about you? So when Grace said she was very community-orientated, automatically I'm interested to know more about her and what involvement she has in the community. And the last one is, does it open the door? So does your elevator pitch lead to further conversation or further connection? So both Grace and I, at the end of our elevator pitch, continued the conversation by asking a question. So for you guys, as you complete your elevator pitch, think of these questions as you refine your elevator pitch, and think about this as framework.
So now that you've spent some time developing your elevator pitch, here are the next steps you can take with yours. Continue to build on your pitch, or build different pitches for different scenarios. For example, going to a networking event, a conference, or a volunteer meetup. Validate your elevator pitch with a few trusted friends and advisors. You want to make sure your view of your brand and the view that others have of you is the same. Revise your elevator pitch, keeping in mind that what you say and what you do should match the brand you want to have. Practicing delivering your elevator pitch, either in front of the mirror, with friends, or at a networking event. You should be able to roll off your tongue with your elevator speech or pitch. Remember that building an elevator pitch isn't an open and done exercise in your career journey. Your brand is always evolving as you grow and change, so you need to revisit it regularly.
Absolutely, and you notice that both Grace and I, when our elevator pitch in university would have changed a lot now to when we're looking for a job. So here are some of the examples of when you can use your elevator pitch and tell your story. So at a networking event when you're meeting someone new. For example, this event, if it was in person, would have been an excellent opportunity. When the hiring manager or recruiter asks, tell me more about yourself at a job interview. Your elevator pitch is also not limited to an in-verbal format. You can tell your story as a bio on your resume and on social media profiles such as LinkedIn. You can also use it as an email introduction to ask someone to meet with you for a coffee or a job shadowing opportunity. An elevator pitch is very versatile, and the opportunity to use your elevator pitch might come at an unexpected time. So being prepared and knowing your narrative is always key.
So your personal brand encompasses the whole you, your values, your actions, your words, and more. This quote from Jay Danzi sums up the power that your personal brand has. Your smile is your logo, your personality is your business card, and how you leave others feeling after having an experience with you becomes your trademark. So to have a great brand, you first have to know yourself and what's great about you. It can also be helpful to know how others see you. We can often be limited by our own sense of self. Getting a fresh perspective can open you to sides of yourself you haven't thought about. Be mindful of what your professional and social media presence says about you and how you make an impression on others. Put your words to good use, promoting your personal brand with your elevator pitch. This short introduction is a great way to share what makes you unique. Make a great first impression and convey your professional presence. It gets easier with time, so keep practicing. Lastly, there is help in many forms. Leverage the people in your network, your friends, family, teachers, and even colleagues. They are often a great resource. There are also lots of resources online, including the RBC Launching Careers Playbook on how to build and practice your brand.
So before we conclude this session, we'd like you to take the time to scan the above QR code. We always value your feedback and hope that you enjoyed today's session.
So your personal brand is only one of the puzzle pieces in your career journey. If you are interested in learning more about how you can navigate and manage your career, regardless of the field you want to be in, check out our Launching Careers Playbook at www.rbc.com/launching-careers, as well as future launch sites at www.rbc.com/future-launch for more tools and resources on how you can kickstart your career. There's also that TED Talk by Amy Cuddy I mentioned earlier on body language that we have there on the screen. So I hope you all had fun during this workshop and that we've provided you with concrete tips and advice to help you build a personal brand and elevator pitch. Thank you for your patience with all of our technology today, and thank you so much for joining us. Have a good day, everyone. Thanks again.
Thank you, guys. Thanks, Grace.
Thanks, Jaylee.